This is Dr. Terry Grossman of Simply Healthy TV, and what I'd like to talk right now about is a brand new field of medicine that is being referred to as regenerative medicine. And I think that regenerative medicine is right on the cusp of revolutionizing how doctors take care of patients. And what regenerative medicine refers to is using tissues that can be helpful in regenerating our own tissues. So let me give you a practical example. We were a football player when we were younger. We played soccer. We ran track. And now we're in our mid-40s and we find we have chronic knee pain. We go see our orthopedic surgeon. The surgeon has injected various substances designed to lubricate and reduce the inflammation. We've been taking some medications. They upset our stomach, whatever the case may be. And now the surgeon tells us, unfortunately, your only option to get rid of this pain is to have a knee replacement. Well, a knee replacement, what they're going to do is they're going to literally take a saw and cut off the bone just below, above the kneecap, cut off the bone just below the kneecap, and take that area and replace it with an artificial knee that consisted of substances like a ball made out of metal and then a plastic plate. And so we become we have a bionic knee. The good news is that in most cases the pain goes away, but the bad news is this procedure only lasts for 10 or 15 years. If we're in our 40s, what are we going to do when we're in our 60s? This is an expensive procedure. It's typically in excess of $50,000. It's a painful procedure. You end up with a scar like this. Unfortunately, once in a while, there are complications associated with it. Most of the time, it goes well, but when it doesn't go well, patients can contract infections, which can be life-threatening. The cement that's used to hold this in place can loosen up. So it's an imperfect procedure. So what we would like to do is something far less painful, far less toxic, far less dangerous, and that's where regenerative medicine comes in. With regenerative medicine, we have the ability to take tissues from that patient to treat that patient. And so, for instance, for the past 7 or 8 years, I've been doing a regenerative treatment for patients with severe arthritis, whether it's in the knees, whether it's in the ankles, the shoulders, the hips, and we take tissues and substances from the patient to treat the patient. So what does that look like? What does a regenerative cell treatment look like? Well, the first thing that I'll do is I'll take a little bit of bone marrow from the patient's hip, typically just in the back area like that. And people think, oh my goodness, a bone marrow, it's terribly painful. Actually, the way that we do it, we just take a little bit of numbing medicine, numb up the bone, take an instrument to enter the bone marrow. If we go slowly, I've had many patients undergo this bone marrow procedure and say, Dr. Grossman, when are you getting ready to begin the procedure? And I'm already done. So it is possible to do this in a very comfortable fashion. Typically might take no more than 5 or 10 minutes. And we just extract a small amount of bone marrow. The reason we like to take the bone marrow to regenerate joints is bone marrow is extremely rich in a type of cell called hematopoietic stem cells. These stem cells have the ability to differentiate into other types of cells that will regenerate tissues. I don't like to say we're doing stem cell therapy. That's why I just use the term regenerative cell therapy. We don't exactly know what happens, but we do know that when we take this bone marrow and inject it into a joint, it recruits, it gives off signaling molecules that recruits healing factors from the body to begin to heal that joint. In addition, well, the advantage with the bone marrow is the healing factors, the cells that are in the bone marrow, are extremely powerful at regrowing tissues. The only advantage, the only disadvantage is that they're not very high in number. So what we like to do is we like to combine them with another source of tissue in the body where we have a huge number. And honestly, the best source that we have is the fat around our midsection. So we like to take less than an ounce of fat from the belly or the love handles region or the hip region. We can extract this with a mini liposuction. Once again, minimally painful, takes 15 minutes to do this. And according to FDA regulations, in order to use regenerative medicine to do cellular therapies where we're taking cells from the patient to treat the patient, we need to follow some rules. And one rule is that we can only use tissues from you to treat you. We can't take, if you're 75 years old, wouldn't you rather take tissues from a 25-year-old? Maybe you would, but that's against the FDA regulations in the United States, so we use your tissues for you. The good news is most of the time that's good enough, more than good enough. So we take the bone marrow tissues, which are filled with the very powerful regenerative cells. We take some fat from the belly. We don't manipulate these tissues in any way, shape, or form. We just wash them off. Sometimes they have a little blood, some of the numbing medicine. So we just put in a syringe and wash it back and forth to make it clean. We inject that directly into the joint. And then finally, we take another substance from the patient, from you, for you, which is your blood. Your blood is rich in a type of blood element called platelets. We centrifuge the platelets to create what's called PRP, platelet-rich plasma. Platelets serve to signal the body to bring other healing elements into the area to cause regeneration of tissue. So basically, to treat a bad hip, one that's bone on bone and needs a replacement, or a knee or an ankle, we do a simple bone marrow, takes a few minutes. We do a simple mini liposuction, takes a few minutes. We take some blood from the arm, painless. Mix these things together in the laboratory, inject them into the joint, follow all the FDA guidelines, and in about 75% of cases, patients notice that they have a dramatic improvement in their pain and they can go on about their business. They're able to get back to playing golf, to playing tennis, and don't need to have these invasive procedures. So instead of having an incision that is 12 inches long, patients that undergo these regenerative therapies drive themselves to the clinic and they drive themselves home with nothing more than a Band-Aid. So this type of Band-Aid surgery, I think, represents a revolution in the way we'll be treating patients with regenerative medicine. So I think that if you have any type of condition that you're looking at needing a joint replacement, that you should begin to research this type of therapy. More and more of the orthopedic surgeons, conventional doctors are beginning to look at this. It's still been a little bit slow to make its way into the mainstream medical community, but doctors like myself have been doing it for over 7 years. We've been having a lot of success with it, and the studies are beginning to come in. There was just recently a study published in the Czech Republic of over 1,100 patients, and over 70% of them were completely satisfied with this procedure. So I think we're on the wave of a brand new form of medicine that could treat many conditions for many of us, and I invite you to learn more about this. My website, www.grossmanwellness.com. My name is Dr. Terry Grossman, and thank you very much for your attention.